Students, in this question we have to evaluate the integral log alpha square cos square theta plus beta square sin square theta between the limit 0 to pi by 2, and we have to show that this is equal to pi log alpha plus beta upon 2. So first we suppose that the integral, given integral, is equal to I is equal to log of alpha square cos square theta plus beta square sin square theta d theta. In this integral, we cannot integrate directly. So, we suppose here we can see that this is the limit of theta. Here, the limit is 0 to pi by 2, and this is the limit of the variable theta here. Here alpha and beta both are independent from the limit 0 to pi by 2. Here this limit 0 to pi by 2 is of the variable theta, and alpha and beta are independent from the limit of integration. In this question, first we differentiate this integral with respect to the parameter alpha, either alpha or beta. So first we differentiate with respect to parameter alpha. So this can be written as di upon d alpha. This is equal to integral 0 to pi by 2. Here d by d alpha of log alpha square cos square theta plus beta square sin square theta d theta. Here we differentiate the given integral I with respect to the parameter alpha. So we write here operator d by d alpha on both the sides. Now we take this d by d alpha inside the integral sign. So by Leibniz rule, this ordinary differential operator d by d alpha convert in partial differential operator, that is del by del alpha. We know that if this d by d alpha goes inside the integral sign, it converts into partial, that is del by del alpha of log of alpha square cos square theta plus beta square sin square theta. Now we differentiate partially this log alpha square cos square theta plus beta square sin square theta with respect to alpha. We know that differentiation of log x with respect to x is 1 upon x. So when we differentiate this, we get 1 upon alpha square cos square theta plus beta square sin square theta. When we differentiate alpha square theta, so cos square theta is constant because we differentiate this partially with respect to alpha. And differentiation of alpha square is 2 alpha. Here beta square sin square theta is also constant because we differentiate this partially with respect to alpha. So differentiation of beta square sin square theta is 0. Now we can see this 2 alpha is constant with respect to theta. So we take this 2 alpha outside the integral. So this is 2 alpha integration between the limit 0 to pi by 2 cos square theta upon alpha square cos square theta plus beta square sin square theta d theta. Now we divide numerator and denominator by cos square theta. So we get here integral 0 to pi by 2 1 upon alpha square plus beta square tan square theta d theta. Here in the numerator we divide by cos square theta, so there will be 1, and here we divide alpha square theta by cos square theta, so we get alpha square. Here beta square sin square theta divide by cos square theta, so we get beta square tan square theta. Now this can be also written as integral between the limit 0 to pi by 2 1 upon alpha square plus beta tan theta whole square. Now we put here beta tan theta is equal to t. So put here t is equal to beta tan theta. Now we differentiate this t with respect to theta. So we get dt upon d theta is equal to beta sec square theta. Because beta is constant, when we differentiate tan theta with respect to theta, we get sec square theta. So dt upon beta is equal to sec square theta d theta. Now we can see here. This dt upon beta and sec square theta can be written as 1 plus tan square theta. We know that sec square theta is equal to 1 plus tan square theta. Now we put value of tan theta, that is in terms of t. So value of tan theta is t upon beta. So this can be written as t square upon beta square d theta. Now we can see here this dt upon beta and beta square plus t square, and this beta square goes in the numerator. Here we write beta square is equal to d theta. In this bracket we take LCM beta square, so we get beta square plus t square upon beta square. Now this square is cancelled by this beta, and this beta goes into the numerator. So this is beta dt upon t square plus beta square is equal to d theta. Now we change the limit here according to t. So when we take theta is equal to 0, that is the lower limit, so t is equal to beta tan 0. And we know that tan 0 is equal to 0, so it becomes 0. When we take lower limit theta is equal to 0, corresponding theta is equal to 0, we get t is equal to 0. Now when we take here theta is equal to pi by 2, that is the upper limit, so t is equal to beta tan pi by 2. And we know that tan pi by 2, that is equal to infinite. So corresponding to theta is equal to pi by 2, here t is equal to infinity. Now the given integral di by d alpha is equal to 2 alpha, and in place of d theta we put here beta dt divided by t square plus beta square, and in place of beta tan theta we put here t. So this is we can write t square alpha square plus t square. Here we write alpha square plus t square. We can see here in place of beta tan theta we put here t. So this is alpha square plus t square. Now we can see here the limit is 0 to infinite. Now this beta is constant with respect to t, so we take this outside the integral sign. So 2 alpha beta here, and 0 to infinity dt upon t square plus alpha square multiplied by t square plus beta square. This is equal to di by d alpha. Now we have to integrate 1 upon t square plus alpha square multiplied by t square plus beta square. So first we do partial fraction of 1 upon t square plus alpha square and t square plus beta square. For partial fraction of this, we suppose that here at plus b upon t square plus alpha square plus ct plus d upon t square plus beta square. Here we do partial fraction of 1 upon t square plus alpha square multiplied by t square plus beta square. So this can be written as at plus b upon t square plus alpha square plus ct plus d upon t square plus beta square. Here a, b, c and d are unknowns. Here a, b, c, d are unknowns which we have to find, which we have to find out. Here Now we taking LCM on the right hand side, so we get here, this is t square plus alpha square t square plus beta square. In the numerator we write here at plus b multiplied by t square plus beta square plus ct plus d multiplied by t square plus alpha square. So here we can see, so we write here, in the left hand side we write here t square plus alpha square and t square plus beta square. In the both the sides we can see here, this t square plus alpha square cancel by this t square plus alpha square and t square plus beta square cancel by this t square plus beta square. So we can see here 1 is equal to here at plus b multiplied by t square plus beta square plus ct plus d multiplied by t square plus alpha square. Now we can see here this is at multiplied by t square, we get at cube, and ct multiplied by t square, we get ct cube. So we take coefficient of t cube in one bracket, that is a plus c. Now here bt square and this dt square, so we write b plus d in front bracket and t square. Now here we can see this is at square at beta square, and here ct alpha square, so we write here a beta square plus c alpha square and t. Here the constant term b beta square plus d alpha square, so b beta square plus d alpha square. Now we equating coefficient of all powers of t. Equating coefficient of all powers of t. So we can see here a plus c is equal to 0 because the coefficient of t cube in the left hand side is 0. This is the first equation. Here the coefficient of t square is equal to b plus d, and in the left hand side coefficient of t square is equal to 0, so b plus d is equal to 0. This is second equation. And in the coefficient of t is a beta square plus c alpha square, and in the left hand side coefficient of t is 0, so this is equal to 0. Now the constant term b beta square plus d alpha square, this is equal to 1. Now from first equation we can see c is equal to minus a, and from second equation we get d is equal to minus b. So we put c is equal to minus a in third, so we get here a beta square minus a alpha square, this is equal to 0. Now we taking common a here, so we get beta square minus alpha square, a is equal to 0, but beta square minus alpha square not equal to 0, so a is equal to 0 here. A is equal to 0, so we get c is equal to 0 because c is equal to minus a here. Now we put d is equal to minus b in equation 4, so we get here b beta square minus b alpha square is equal to 1. Taking common b in these two terms, so we get here beta square minus alpha square, b is equal to 1, so b is equal to 1 upon beta square minus alpha square. This is the value of b. Now we find the value of d. So we know that d is equal to minus b, so it becomes minus 1 upon beta square minus alpha square. Now we put value of a, b, c, d in the partial fraction, so we get di upon d alpha is equal to 2 alpha beta, and here this 1 upon t square plus alpha square multiplied by t square plus beta square, this is equal to, value of a is 0 here, and value of b is 1 upon beta square minus alpha square multiplied by t square plus alpha square. Similarly, when we put here c is equal to 0 and d is equal to minus time, so this is minus 1 upon beta square minus alpha square multiplied by t square plus beta square and dt. Now we taking here common v square beta square minus alpha square in both the terms. So this can be written as 2 alpha beta divided by beta square minus alpha square. Here 1 upon t square plus alpha square minus 1 upon t square plus beta square. Now we integrate this 1 upon t square plus alpha square. So we get here 1 upon a. A is alpha here. Tan inverse x upon a, yani t upon alpha. And here the integration of this 1 upon beta tan inverse t upon beta. Now we put here value of t, that is the upper limit minus lower limit. So this is 2 beta upon beta square minus alpha square. When we put upper limit in place of t, that is infinity, so we get tan inverse infinity minus 1 upon beta tan inverse infinity. This is the upper limit, and when we substitute 0 in the low, that is the lower limit in place of t, we get 0 here. So we know that this is 2 alpha beta upon beta square minus alpha square, and tan inverse infinity, this is equal to pi by 2 minus, this is also pi by 2. So pi by 2 into 1 upon beta. Now we taking common pi by 2 in these two terms. So we get here 2 alpha beta upon beta square minus alpha square. We taking common pi by 2, and here we taking LCM, that is alpha beta. So here beta minus alpha. Now we factorize this beta square minus alpha square. So we get here di upon d alpha. This is equal to 2 alpha beta divided by beta plus alpha beta minus alpha. We know that the factorization of beta square minus alpha square, that is beta plus alpha beta minus alpha multiplied by pi by 2 beta minus alpha divided by alpha beta. Now we can see here this beta minus alpha cancelled by this beta minus alpha, this alpha beta cancelled by this alpha beta, this 2 is cancelled by this. So we find here di upon d alpha is equal to pi upon alpha plus beta. Now we find here di upon d alpha is equal to pi upon alpha plus beta. So Now we find here di upon d alpha is equal to pi upon alpha plus beta. So this can be written as di is equal to pi upon alpha plus beta multiplied by d alpha. Now we integrate this. So integration of di is I, here pi is constant, and integration of 1 upon alpha plus beta, and c is the integration constant. So I is equal to pi, and the integration of 1 upon alpha plus beta, where beta is the constant because we integrate with respect to alpha. So this is log of alpha plus beta, and plus c is the integration constant. Suppose that this is the equation second. Now we put alpha is equal to beta is equal to 1 in 1. So we get here I is equal to 0 to pi by 2 log of cos square theta plus sin square theta. In the given integral, we put alpha is equal to 1, beta is equal to 1. So we get I is equal to integration between the limit 0 to pi by 2 log cos square theta plus sin square theta. And we know that cos square theta plus sin square theta, this is equal to 1. So this can be written as 0 to pi by 2 log of 1 d theta. And log 1, this is equal to 0. So I is equal to 0 here. Now we put alpha is equal to beta is equal to 1 in equation second. So I is equal to pi log 1 plus 1 plus c. And we know that when alpha and beta both are 1, value of I is 0 here. And this is pi log 1 plus 1 2 plus c. So c is equal to minus times pi log 2. Now we put value of c, that is the integration constant, in equation 2. So we get I is equal to pi log alpha plus beta minus pi log 2. Now we taking common pi from both the terms. So here we can see this is pi log alpha plus beta minus log 2. And we know that from the property of logarithm, we know that this is log alpha plus beta divided by 2. So this is the integral of the, this is the value of the given definite integral. Thank you.